happening right now in Athens. Also, I will ask you to stay for the whole duration of the performance, of the concert. But if you want to stay to live in the middle of it, you're going to have to use this door and give us something before you go, in order for us to learn and improve from your comments. Also, we have to speak one by one because of the acoustics of the room in order to be able to hear each other. So, if you don't want to participate, or you don't want to be seen, or you know that you're not going to be able to stay for the whole hour, maybe it's better for you and for us if you leave now. Can anyone repeat what I just said to the new people? What?
Are you here by yourself?
And you?
No.
You?
I'm not older than 30.
Sorry, you asked 30. How old are you?
I'm 20.
Ah, so why don't you say so? And you?
Are you only staying here for today?
No, till Sunday.
Who of you would actually leave now this room?
So why did you come here?
For this performance, because I'm curious about what happened.
So what are your expectations?
No specific expectations.
Do you like this room?
No, I can't. I like the room visually, but I do not like the echo. It's difficult for me to hear.
You can all answer.
How are you feeling now?
Excited.
Why did you choose to go to the answer side and not to be on the question side as we are?
It's more challenging. Yeah. I already stood here. Because it is easier to answer than to ask questions.
Do you feel a relation to city of Athens now?
Yes.
Do you like noise?
Do you like what?
Do you like noise?
And which was the question?
where does sex start? So David.
You're not supposed to ask though.
I was thinking loud.
Every day. Why do you feel so uncomfortable talking about it? What do you think?
It shows the injustice of the situation.
Okay, now I can change groups.
Que se fosse um filme de illness.
I don't think so.
We hope so.
Was there a question you didn't ask because you didn't dare?
Can you repeat?
Was there a question you didn't ask because you didn't dare?
Yeah, I wanted to ask if you two are a couple. No, but I am answering to you. Yes.
Can you explain how and how does it feel?
If anyone else wants to answer also, then we can do it together.
How we suffer from capitalism?
If
you're saying. I don't think so, because basically we are on the winning side of capitalism and we are making others suffer for our need to consume, so.
I think we feel very comfortable. Too comfortable probably to ask questions we should ask.
I think we are definitely on the comfortable side of capitalism.
Yes.
Every time I take a shitty job to survive.
I do not remember the question.
What?
I do not remember the question.
If you suffer from capitalism in your personal life,
times yes, times no, it depends.
Well, it's hard to think outside of capitalism, so it's like asking whether we suffer from there.
Of course.
Which question?
When you ask someone with sex.
Yeah,
and
if it was.
That was less uncomfortable than the art related to the do you want to make a.
No, I think it was about the answer. So the art question is about the answer and the sex related question, because the sex related question was basically just telling facts and the art question was really about opinions.
Did you prefer being on this side of the room?
Yes.
Why do you think there are no people of color here?
There are no people?
There are hardly any in the documentary. There are hardly any in the documentary.
What people want to
of color?
Within art and the difference in politics. Difference or change something actually?
Well, it can change the way people think that we can actually change injustices or just things in the world.
I think it's more common in the situation that people, for example, so there are definitely some people not because are not able or want to participate in this kind of event. I think
it
won't change.
And how do you feel being part of a spectacle of maybe a situation you can imagine as being on the right side of capitalism? Not the right side, but privileged side of the privileged side of
I guess I feel quite normal since that's our normal situation to live on this bright side actually. And we do it every day in our daily life and normally we don't get into problems and just be on the surface and feel quite comfortable with it.
Do you think this project can bring you to more problems in this sense?
It could. Maybe not in a long-term view, but short-term wise, yes.
What do you think about feeling uncomfortable? Does it change something?
Yes.
What does it change?
The blood pressure.
What?
The blood pressure.
Have you ever cried out of political reasons?
Yes.
Yes.
No.
Who said no?
I said no.
Only you?
So.
Ah.
What was the specific reason?
It seems kind of dumb, but like, why there's so many people apparently so unhappy that they would just go all the way to discriminate against others to make themselves feel better, I guess.
Did you cry this week?
Stupid, but yeah. Yes. Hands. We can let this movement of her hands take away also the rest of her body. Okay, make a leap steps from here, like that. Yeah. Okay. So, we're trying to make the collective subject. Keep going, I'll be talking, don't mind. So, we're trying to make the collective subject, but we don't know how to do it. So, now that we have known each other a little better, and that we have relaxed very much, as possible, maybe you could suggest something. I mean, we have to make the collective subject. We have somehow to achieve collectivity, it is true, but we don't know how. So please help us. We're desperate here. Yeah, because say something.
We have tried a lot of different things and we don't know what really what.
Singing.
Yes, we can try.
Let's sing.
Thank you.
taking a deep breath. Listen to the room.
What?
To tap our mouth. Our mouth.
At the same time. I was really going at the same time.
Okay.
So, one, two, three.
No, no.
Yes.
One.
Nice to meet you.
I think that many works really try to make you like feel shame or something.
Yeah.
Like wow, like what you said, there are no colored people here because they are the object, not the subject of the community.
Mm-hmm.
But I think it's more interesting not to feel shame or just to understand the world and to think how it works and what world we play. And I think
support, for instance, that it reminds us of something that we tend to forget, or we know this world, our world, so well, but it's more about being informed, knowing the world, than
guilt or shame.
Yeah.
Sausages, mm-hmm. And still eat them sometimes.
So, we think there are no oppressed people in this room, but you made the question and only four men applied.
That's an observation.
Just an observation. Go on.
So you want me to reply to my question?
No, just an observation.
How many people have been documented before?
seen much yet.
The previous one was more about art, and this one is more about social and political problems. I don't have a preference for either.
I think it's hard.
What was the first document that you saw?
Mine was the one 10 years ago. It's great. I love that. This one is harder because you have to grapple with a lot of realities that you take in other ways through the news throughout the rest of the year, but you don't experience it, you know, with art or this concept quite in the same way, so it hits you harder sometimes. It's hard to realize.
I'm just curious about how many people here have a job which is related to art or something like a, yeah, music or some dance.
There's
so it looks like being something for insides.
What I'm thinking about all the time that I'm working around here is I also follow a lot of, let's say, right-wing economists on the internet, and I think it's a pity that those two worlds don't meet. There are a lot of intelligent, good-meaning right-wing people. I'm not right-wing myself. And there are a lot of intelligent and good left-wing people. And
why can't they talk?
Why can't they talk? Yes.
Yeah, I agree.
I'm afraid not a lot of right-wing intelligent people go to the documenta, and it's a pity.
I think
it's
exclusive, definitely, because everything is so in one direction. I think it's not many pieces of art are not that open. And you think, like, yeah, I'm thinking about it, but rather, okay, this is an opinion. Like, if you see the one at the castle down there, like, that's bad and that's good, isn't it? I don't know, it's not an event to have a discussion or to start a discussion. It's rather commenting.
In this sense, this kind of political topic, this documenta, what do you think? Is it like preaching to the believers? It's not hard to convince people who are in this business or in this left-wing circle to convince them about this. What
struck me that there's an image of the snake eating itself. Mm-hmm.
There are theories which says that artists see farther into the future than other people, and if this is the future, it will not be good.
Well, this is the future. Does anybody know a case where a thinker from the right and a thinker from the left can talk to each other?
Do you think how much?
In
But why should they?
Yeah, why should they?
And is there not two poles between right wing and left wing? It's not a pole. I mean, maybe the two poles are oppressors, oppressors and oppressed. And sometimes the oppressors can be right wing and left wing.
I suppose that's a way of looking at it. But sometimes somebody's opinion is about a thing, it's called truth. is on one side and then somebody else's opinion is on the other, and maybe there's something that can be done that can bring it, I don't know, into more justice than the way it is now.
But this is exactly the problem that left-wing people are accusing of right-wing people, that are their injustice socially. So this doesn't make any sense.
So you're saying that there's nothing to be done.
What do you think that there is to be done? Justice? No.
Maybe there isn't. I think that on the one hand, you can become resigned to the reality that that one human life is at the expense of another, period. And that's hard to admit, that what you have is at the expense of another, or maybe many others. But maybe that's all that there is. If you take it just as a binary rule, just by taking up space, somebody else can't take your space. It's just a mess.
How many people here is a belief? I think we have all or think that capitalism is a really not just a one, should be so as keep going. So something like something there must be something changing or something alternative is real, and you believe some that socialism or communism or new something left wing ideology could be the one of the alternatives. Because of where I come from, the Korea, I think the Korean people doesn't care about that, what is socialism, what is capitalism, but we are really formed as we are really capitalism society. But people think that as long as we can eat, we can live in peace, we have a really enemy, big enemy. But as long as we are good and eat and okay, whatever, capitalism, okay, or socialism, I think we are really, that means really flexible, something like that. So when socialism, okay, when we with socialism, so good life, when we have good life. I personally have a such experience, or with my parents, or with my friends, and although we have some left-wing parties, which is really weak, really, we have just two parties, like America, so really like right-wing and a little bit right. No, so I came here and then asked something. So here, I think Germany is a really a social democratic commercial land. I want to ask, how do you think about the alternative ideology?
Well, the thing is that you are always speaking like if left wing and right wing would be equal, and I think that's a mistake, because it's not actually like left wing practically doesn't exist nowadays in reality, which is really a pity, but it just doesn't. There's like right wing and left wing that behaves like right wing, basically. And that's it. And then when you really try to be left, then you're accused as a communist that wants to destroy the world, which is what is happening in my country. There's an opportunity for great people to be like in a new government and fix things, and people just want to vote it and vote it again. This right wing that destroyed their lives completely.
as well as left-wing politicians don't want to say wrong things, so they don't want to say untruths. That's why it's just not a safety problem.
You know, there are some people like that, but actually,
yeah, but
Portugal is a country with some sort of like,
but I mean, isn't it because it's just maybe too hard? Because as a politician, you have to be like, because that's your job.
No, it's because there's a very strong economical and political establishment that had run these tasks very slowly and very calculated in the past 11 years for really destroying this middle class. That's why people now like fight to keep the few things that they left us with.
Yeah.
And that's why we respond exactly as they want, which is being racist, being afraid of people that are different, and that's why we are going backwards.
Yeah, but this happens to Spain, or?
It happens everywhere.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm from Spain and I live in Germany, so I just speak from my point of view of how my life is, but for example, I'm the perfect case of a person that is not able to live in her country. I don't have a choice. I have to go for whatever I want. And I have to work and study both since I'm 18 years old. I've never been in 1 year from my parents, nothing. Which is fine because I don't know, but like, I'm not the only one. In my family, there are like millions of people like me right now everywhere.
Yeah, I'm Greek, so
yeah.
It's pretty much the same.
Yeah.
But when somebody, I think you or you, I don't know, somebody asked the question if we are disappointed from capitalism or if there is a problem with this, most of the people said no, because we are in the privileged side. And maybe, I don't know, German people, I'm trying to understand what's going on here. And maybe German people are very happy. I mean, maybe they are cool with that, they can have a good life inside capitalism, but can they? I mean, if your only problem is about how you feel ashamed of exploiting other people like the South or the Third World, don't be. If you feel if everything else is okay and you're happy in your life with this everyday life, I think that to me the question is, yeah, I have a big question mark from this point of the concert today and so on, but yeah, the truth is why? If I mean, don't we have a problem even if we have an iPhone that, you know, we don't have sociability, we don't have a collectivity, we don't have social relationships, we don't have a narration for our lives, like a meaning, as you said. Our only problem is that we feel ashamed of exploiting others? I don't know. To me, it does not work this way. I mean, I understand the problems of capitalism and that there is no way that it can continue in my everyday life. And except from the point that you already said that, yeah, there is a crisis and blah, 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 and maybe I have to leave my country, blah, 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 and my friends are leaving and I have to work while studying at the same time. But also, above from all that, in the huge contradiction between how I have to be in order to survive and how I want to be in order to be happy. And I think this is universal.
I'm also very, very, I believe also very much that I'm also embedded in this system. It's like, I'm also myself identified in this. My knowledge, for example, that I bought with money of the work of my dad, or in all this, I am also inside there. I don't know how to separate myself and see it from an outside perspective. So I think this is what this is about, how to see this from an outside perspective, and even if you are embedded in all these mediations.